Today on Qlik All the Ops, we are configuring Azure Active Directory to work with Qlik Enterprise SaaS so that you can get friendly group names. In the past, ADFS was your best option for connecting Azure AD with Qlik Enterprise SaaS. But that led to a bad user experience because instead of friendly group names, you get these GUIDs that kind of remind you of license keys you used to enter in for software. You don't want unfriendly GUIDs, you want friendly group names. And the new Azure AD option in the IdP configuration contacts Microsoft Graph on the backend to resolve those GUIDs into friendly group names when users authenticate. And today, I'll show you how all that works. First, I'll configure Azure Active Directory to authenticate users to Qlik. Then, we'll connect Qlik up to Azure Active Directory to complete the flow. And last, we'll test it out. And for more information on deleting GUIDs, click on the link below that shows you how to go ahead and delete those groups using Qlik CLI. Connecting applications like Qlik to Azure Active Directory uses a concept known as app registrations. App registrations are configurations that have the settings and permissions enabling Qlik to access Azure Active Directory as an identity provider to authenticate users. From the Azure portal, go into the Azure Active Directory and choose Create New App Registration. Give the new registration a name and then supply the redirect URI. The redirect URI is also known as the callback URL, and that URL represents where Azure will send information to after it completes authenticating the user. Keep in mind that the redirect URI uses the original host name for your Qlik Enterprise SaaS tenant. If you attempt to use the tenant alias, it's not going to work. So get that information, store it in your notepad, and then leverage that in this configuration setting. Then add /login/callback to complete the URI. Register the application and head back to the overview. Next up is creating a client secret. The client secret, along with the client ID, is a key pair that's used to identify Qlik as the registered application that is authenticating users to the Active Directory. Client secrets are configured in the Certificates and Secrets screen. Generate a new client secret by giving it a name, and that will produce a value, which is the secret. The ID that's next to that value is not the client ID. The client ID is on the overview page, and we're going to discuss that shortly. Record this new secret value in your notepad. Just be aware, it will not be visible once you navigate away from this screen. Don't worry, you can always create another if you didn't capture it this time around. I mentioned the client ID a moment ago. That's located on the overview page, and it's listed as the application ID. Copy that value and place it in your notepad. Next, we'll click on the Endpoints button, which is on the top menu, and this will reveal a list of endpoints that are used for authorizing and authenticating users to this app registration. Notice that there are endpoints for OAuth2, SAML, and OpenID Connect. This app registration will handle requests from all of those different authorization and authentication capabilities, but we care about OpenID Connect. So we're going to copy the endpoint for our configuration inside of Qlik later on. Authentication sends user information in the form of claims through a token. That token will contain things like the email address of the user, the name of the user, and in this case, the groups that the user is a member of. And we want to make sure that that's configured properly so that the right information is sent to Qlik for Qlik to be able to process it and authenticate the user. An app registration sends some default claims that are required in a valid token. Claims like the subject, the name, client ID are all included in every token that's sent from Azure. Everything else is an optional claim. Optional claims are additional profile information that you want or need to send to the application that's being registered. From the side panel, you can add the optional claims that you want to include in the token. The most important addition for me is the UPN because it contains the email address for the user that I want them to have when they log into Qlik. When you look down the list, there's a ton of different optional claims that have the word email in them. Why are there so many of them? Well, Azure is like the multi-tenant service. So you can have multiple identities in the Azure world with multiple different email addresses. And Azure doesn't actually know which one is your primary email or your verified email or your validated email. It gives you places and placeholders where you can add that, like the primary verified email claim, and there's a secondary one as well. But for the most part, those are all going to be empty. In addition to that, there's an email verified claim that's a standard claim of OpenID Connect that Azure doesn't send, which Qlik requires. So why don't they do this? Well, I'll let Auth0 explain. In Azure AD, depending on how the Azure AD tenant is configured, email addresses returned by Azure AD may or may not correspond to office mailboxes. Auth0 can't know whether they do or not. The article from Auth0, and Qlik is the same way, but the article from Auth0 states that for Azure configurations, Auth0 added a switch that admins can set for the email verified, which is a Boolean true-false value, to true in all cases, so that you can overcome this email verified issue. Adding optional claims may require additional permissions for the app registration. If prompted, accept those additional permissions, and then we can move on to adding groups into this configuration. But I'm not going to click the Add Optional Group Claims button in this section, because all that will do is set me up to bring the GUIDs back over into Qlik. Instead, I want to go to the API permissions and establish a connection to Microsoft Graph to bring the group names into the app registration. The API permissions overview shows the scopes that I've added from the optional claims selections that I made earlier. Now I need to add the permission that will send group-friendly names in the token, and that's called groupmember.read.all. The way that we find it is it's buried a little bit under the Microsoft Graph delegated permissions. Delegated permissions allow the application to access the user profile information on behalf of the user. So we're going to search for groups and then pick groupmember.read.all and add that additional permission to the app registration. Reading group information requires granting admin consent to give the user access to this permission. What granting consent means is it will give the user a smoother login experience the first time that they log into Qlik. So go ahead and grant that consent for all of the different scopes. So that completes the Azure portion of the configuration. But before I move on to the Qlik configuration, I just want to take you to the user I'm going to use to test, Hardcore Harry, and show you the groups that he's a member of. These are the groups and the friendly names that we expect once the configuration is complete and we log in as Harry into Qlik to show up when we create a space. Okay, let's get into configuring Qlik to work with Azure AD. If you are a tenant admin in Qlik Enterprise SaaS, you can get to the management console by going up to your avatar and choosing administration from the drop-down menu. Once you're in the management console, group support is off by default. So if you haven't turned it on before, you need to go into settings, and then there's a switch that allows you to turn on support for groups. Go ahead and turn that on and make it available for your identity provider. Grab your notepad and make sure that you've got the client ID, the client secret, and the endpoint URL for when we get started in the configuration. Select identity provider from the menu on the left, and that will present a window with a create new button on the right. Click that button, choose interactive for the type, and then Azure AD for the provider. Once you pick from the second dropdown, it will surface input boxes that will allow you to complete the configuration. Under Application Credentials, add the OpenID endpoint in the Azure AD configuration input, and then the client ID in the client secret in their respective input boxes. Earlier, I spoke about claims and how they represent the information about the user logging into the system. This next section is where we will be able to set those claims to what we want to have mapped into Qlik. For more information about claims and claim mapping values, I've got a link below to a blog that goes into this in a bit more detail. In the claims mapping section, I'm making one change, and that's to the email claim. Instead of email, I'm changing it to UPN, one of the optional claims that I've added to the app registration. I know it contains the user's email address, so that's why I want to go ahead and use it. After I've set that to the UPN, the last claim that I want to consider in this configuration is email verified. Now you're going to see that there's an optional section. And if you recall earlier, I talked about how email verified is a standard claim of OpenID Connect, but it's not provided by Azure, and that Auth0 had a nice handy switch for basically setting every email that comes through as a verified email when you configure Azure AD with their system. Well, we just conveniently stole their idea and implemented the same thing underneath the advanced options of the IdP configuration in Qlik. Open up the advanced options and slide that puppy on to true. With all the settings filled out, you press create, and that triggers a confirmation to save the identity provider. Then it triggers a validation process. What's going to happen is Qlik's going to contact Azure and prompt for credentials. And I go ahead and I'm going to log in as Harry. And on a successful login, a verification screen will appear that looks like this. This screen shows the user and their subject and different information about them. Qlik through the verification and you can set the validation user as a tenant admin. And I highly recommend this because what's going to happen is if you go through this process and you activate the IDP, you're now transferring from using the identity provider you're using before, which could be the Qlik account or it could be ADFS, depending on if you're converting. And you want to make sure that whomever you're logging in is going to be the tenant admin so that you can log out and log back in. After you've done the activation, then the identity provider configuration is complete and you're ready to go. Okay, so now we're ready to test it out. So let's just go ahead and log out completely. You may have to do this a couple of times. I know it's a bit wonky, but for whatever reason, you may end up being logged in twice as part of this identity provider configuration. So you log in, log out all the way, and then you log in, and let's go ahead and create a shared space. And if you look at the members that you can add into that shared space, you'll see that if everything went swell, groups with friendly names from Azure are in the list of available values. And for me, they are. You can see I've got finance, and then I've got my other specific content admins and other groups that are members here. So everything worked out really great. So there are a lot of steps to configure Qlik and Azure AD to work together for authentication. The Qlik part's pretty easy, but the Azure Active Directory connection capabilities, they've got a lot of steps. And so you want to take it slow because one missed configuration can lead to a lot of troubleshooting and it just becomes a pretty big time sink. Hopefully this video saves you that time. Let me know what you think of this video and others in the comments below. And we'll see you on Qlik Community, where you can join the conversation and learn more. See you there.